Starting a campaign, though, I'm beginning a conversation with you, with America, because we all need to be part of this
discussion. If we're all going to be a part of the solution.
About how to bring the right end to the war in Iraq and to restore respect for America around the world, how to make us energy independent and free of foreign oil, how to end the deficit that threatens social security
and Medicare. And let's definitely talk about how every American can have quality, affordable health care.
You know, after 6 years of George Bush, it's time to renew the basic promise of America. No matter who you are, no matter where you live, if you work hard and play by the rules, you can build a good life for yourself and your I grew up in a middle-class family in the middle of America, and we believed in that promise. Keep up our rest.
let's talk. So let's chat. Listen a dialogue about your ideas and mine, because the conversation has been a little one-sided lately, don't you think? And we all can see how that worked.
Last night, I congratulated Donald Trump
and offered to work with him.
This is not the outcome we wanted or worked so hard for. And I'm sorry we did not for the values we share and the vision we hold for our country.
But for this wondrous campaign that we built together, this vast, diverse, creative, unruly, energized campaign. You represent the best of America, and being your candidate has been one of the greatest.
I know how disappointed you feel, because I feel it too. And now, soldo tens of millions of Americans who invested their hopes and dreams in this effort.
This is painful.
Donald Trump is going to be our president. We owe him an open mind and a chance to lead. Our Constitution enshrines the peaceful transfer of power, and we don't just respect that, we cherish it.
Dignities, freedom. is to keep doing our part to build that bigger, stronger, fairer America we seek. And I know you will. I am so grateful to stand with all of you.
You poured your heart into this campaign. For some of you who are veterans, it was a campaign. After you had done other campaigns, I want each of you to know that this was the best campaign anyone could have ever expected or wanted.
And to the millions of volunteers, community leaders, activists, and union organizers who knocked on doors, talked to neighbors, posted on Facebook, even on secret private Facebook sites.
Still not shattered that highest and hardest glass ceiling, but someday someone will, and sooner than you might think right now.
Grateful to have.
another gathering being held today in Washington, D.C. Someone is raising his hand and taking a most important oath of office. Many of us gathered here had expended great energy, time, and faith in the hope that the person raising her hand today and swearing to uphold the Constitution and lead our great nation into the future would have been Hillary Clinton. The disappointment, especially from many here in the artistic community, is deep and palpable. Though we cannot change the outcome, we can do something of value to commemorate her dedication and strength. Using some of her own inspiring words set to music for this occasion, we can honor her vision, her service, and her undying love for our nation. And though she cannot raise her hand to take the presidential oath today, we can raise our voices to remind the world that sometimes out of disappointment can come something very special called art.
Now I know we have still not shattered that highest and hardest glass ceiling, but someday, someone will, and sooner than you might think right now.